I mean, there have been very few to think of, but I guess it has to be the Test 100 because that was very special. Whenever I went into bat, I always believed that I could score 100. And I got a fiver against Pakistan where one wicket I got off the left-hander bowling leg break because there was a bit of rough. And the other four right-handers I got bowling medium pace. So that was the only time that I bowled seam up. So yes, I don't know why I became a bowler, but I always believed that I could bat. Right from day one, I believed that I could score 100. I kept trying. So it happened in my 117th test match that I finally got my test 100. But I always believed that I could bat and I could, I couldn't really force. I was not a six hitter, but I could certainly, hold a bat and make the bowler really work hard to get me out. Oh, it's. I think it's a lot. What you think, how you prepare. I think yes, mind over matter is a lot. Yes, you definitely need skill, whether you're a batsman or a bowler or in any format. But I think most importantly, the mind needs to be really, really positive, and that plays a very, very important role. So the preparation of one's mind going into any match is extremely critical, and I think that's the most important aspect. What the mind is thinking, your body responds, and invariably, it's not just on the day of the match, but leading up to the match as well, because the subconscious mind takes over when you're actually in the middle. So it's very important to sort of plan and prepare properly in the mind when you're playing a match. So the lead up to a match is extremely crucial. I'll talk from a bowler's perspective in a match situation. So length is mandatory. Line, of course, can be dependent on the batsman. And those metrics are critical. So the number of deliveries that you bowl in a match or at practice will obviously help you deliver better under pressure. And then we spoke about the mind, the importance of the mind in a physical game like cricket. So I don't think you can measure as a metric. So irrespective of batsman, bowler, whatever you are in cricket, what is your attitude? Line, of course, can be dependent on the batsman. And those metrics are critical. So the number of deliveries that you bowl in a match or at practice will obviously help you deliver better under pressure. And then we spoke about the mind, the importance of the mind in a physical game like cricket. So that I don't think you can measure as a metric. So irrespective of batsman, bowler, whatever you are in cricket, what is your attitude? Do you have a winning attitude irrespective of what the position of the game is in? I had this during my time. I'm sure it would have improved my game, at least the power hitting game in one day cricket. There's not much T20 anyway that I played. I never played T20 international. But if I have to pick one who's still going strong, with King's 11 as well. I mean, it has to be the universe boss. Chris Gayle, probably even today, he would lead most batters. I know Andre Russell won the power shot challenge, but Chris Gayle is not too far behind. And in his heyday, I mean, there's nobody who could hit harder than someone like Chris Gayle. But yes, Chris Gayle, Adam Gilchrist. Sachin Tendulkar would hit the ball really hard. Sehwag was someone who was very different. But I think if I have to pick one, a couple of guys who probably really smashed it, Lance Klusener and Chris Gayle, probably who sort of used a lot of strength as well, not just timing.